This video is an overview of how to perform a foil test on your ultrasonic. However, always refer to the appropriate technical documentation for the complete list of instructions, safety alerts, and sequence of procedures before conducting any service or maintenance operations. The purpose of a foil test is to determine the efficiency of your ultrasonic cleaner. Quarterly testing of the ultrasonic cleaner is recommended. Testing should also be performed whenever deterioration in the cleaner performance is suspected. The foil test is relatively easy to perform and will provide a permanent record for the future comparative evaluation of your ultrasonic cleaner's performance. Step 1. Obtain a roll of any standard weight household aluminum foil. Step 2. Make a support to which the aluminum foil will be attached. The material isn't critical. It just needs to be able to provide support that can be laid across the top of the tank to provide a support to attach the foil to. For this example, we will use a strip of autoclave indicator tape 2 inches longer than the length of your ultrasonic. Step 3. Cut a piece of foil approximately 6 inches in length and long enough to attach to the support and suspend almost to the bottom of the tank. The foil must not touch the bottom or sides of the tank. Attach the foil to the support. Care should be taken to avoid crinkling of the foil. Cut the aluminum foil if needed so that it will fit the tank without touching. Check the length. Step 4. With the foil test sample removed from the tank, prepare a fresh ultrasonic cleaner solution by filling the tank to the fill line with the water. Then, add the recommended amount of cleaning solution. Step 5. Turn the ultrasonic on and run the degas cycle for 10 minutes to degas the solution. Step 6. With the ultrasonic cleaner off and the basket removed, lower the foil sample into the center of the tank, positioning it so the foil isn't touching the sides or bottom of the tank. Note: for larger units, for example, QuickClean QC6, multiple samples should be used to get a better sampling of the uniformity of the ultrasonic cavitation in the tank. Step 7. Turn the ultrasonic cleaner on for 1 minute. Remove the foil sample, allowing the excess cleaning solution to drain off the foil. Allow the sample to air dry, being careful not to wrinkle the foil. The foil surface submerged in the solution should be uniformly covered with a small dimpling or pebbling effect over the entire surface. There may also be some holes in the foil as a result of erosion caused by the interaction between the cleaning solution, the foil, and the ultrasonic action. But the objective of this test is to see how uniform the pebbling is, not how many holes are in the foil. If there are an excessive number of holes in the foil sample, run another test, decreasing the exposure time to get a better sampling of the uniformity of the dimpling. The entire submerged area of the foil should be uniformly pebbled with tiny dimples from the ultrasonic implosions. Areas greater than 1 inch diameter, the size of a quarter, that doesn't have pebbling may indicate that there's a problem with the ultrasonic unit. If the results indicate a possible problem, repeat the above steps using a new foil sample. If the results are the same, contact your service provider to have the unit evaluated or repaired. If the results confirm uniform cavitation, dimpling, pebbling of the foil throughout the tank, label, date, and save the foil test sample for future comparative purposes. Drain and clean the unit prior to cleaning instruments, as the solution left in the tank is foil contaminated. For more detailed information about your ultrasonic, please refer to the QuickClean User Guide. For further support, contact Midmark Support Services at 1-800-MIDMARK.